blue smoke is a pretty word, don't you think? Or two pretty words. As a matter of fact, that title came from what I was going to call a bluegrass band. I was doing some bluegrass music a few years ago, and I was trying to think of names that I thought would be pretty for a band that, you know, that specialized in bluegrass. And I thought, Blue Smoke. I thought, that's a good title. But I never did call the band that. So I thought, well, I do like that title, so I need to write a song about that. And I thought, well, now, what would I write about? I thought, well, now, where would I get blue smoke? What would I write about? I thought, well, I guess maybe I could write about a jet. But then, no, I thought a train, because I love train songs. And I thought, well, now, what will I say about a train song? I thought, well, when you think about traveling, you think about leaving. Usually when you think about leaving, if you're a country star, you got to, you know, you got to weave that heartbreak in. So I thought, well, this would be a good name for the name of a train. So I thought, well, Blue Smoke is the name of the train that I am riding on. So it was like a heartbreak train. So it actually came from a band title, turned into a song, turned into the name of the CD, and also to the name of the world tour. But it also kind of hints at the fact that there's several bluegrass flavored songs in the CD. So that title worked really well for me, I thought.
I ask my love to take a walk.
Just Banks of the Ohio. That's a song I've been singing since I was a little kid. My mama was a great singer, and she used to sing all those old songs from the old world. And she used to tell us that that's how people used to carry the news, because most of those old songs really tell true stories. And this one, from what I understand, happened, oh, hundreds of years ago, where somebody kind of killed their girlfriend because they wouldn't marry him. That's an awful reason to take somebody out, ain't it? But it's a good song. It's a sad song. And it's always been kind of like a man's song. It's from a man's perspective. So I got the idea. I thought, well, I want to sing it. So I wrote a whole new little intro to where I was like a journalist, like I was going into the prison to talk to this person of why this happened. So the first verse and a couple of little things I added within the song from a journalist standpoint, to kind of make it a little more personal where more women could sing it. So I'm hoping that as the years go by, more women might want to sing Banks of the Ohio. So see how you like this one. It's one of my favorites. And in no way. Bob Dylan has always been one of my favorite songwriters. He's a great poet, as we all know, but I just love the way he puts things together. I mean, they're just so real. And the song, I just thought, really kind of fit a lot of people. Even if we're happy with the person that we're with, and if we spend our whole lives with them, there are those times where we kind of feel like that we're taken for granted, and maybe things ain't going as well. And even if we're not really going to leave, we kind of fantasize it when we're not feeling good. Kind of little spiteful feelings that we have. But sometimes we just up and go. And that's kind of what this song's about. It's like there's no point hanging around here because it ain't never going to work, so I'm out of here. So I just love the song, and I thought it really fit well into the types of songs that we were doing in the CD.
That light I never know. Ain't no use.
Unlikely Angel. Now, some of you out there might remember that many, many years ago, I did a TV movie of the week with Roddy McDowell, one of my favorite people in the whole world. There were a lot of other wonderful stars in that as well. That was the name of the TV movie of the week. It was a Christmas movie. And I wrote the song for it. And I just always thought the song was really, really pretty. It was one of my better songs, I thought. But nobody ever heard it because it was just done in the movie. And of course, there was not a soundtrack or anything. And so when I got ready to put the Blue Smoke CD together, I remembered that song. I thought, I'm going to drag that out and see if that's still as good as I believed it was at the time. So I played it, and everybody said, yeah, that's good. Let's do that. So I was happy to get a chance to actually represent that and do it like a real record. And it's one of my favorites in the whole CD, and hopefully you'll like it as well.
Unlikely angel, it feels so right inside you.